Hi friends, let's study Q10 and Q11 of ISBP 745, contents of the certificate under analysis, inspection, health, phytosanitary, etc. certificates. Q10. A certificate may indicate as the consignor or the exporter an entity other than the beni of the credit or the shipper as shown on any other stipulated document. This happens in transfer LC. Here the issuing bank issues the LC to the first beni transfers it to the second beni ships the goods directly to the issuing bank or the applicant and then sends the goods to the first beni, sends the documents to the first beni. Now, when he sends the documents, this first beni will replace the documents sent by the second beni. Now, if this first beni does not replace the certificates provided, like phytosanitary or whatever certificate it might be, definitely he can't replace, because how will he produce a new certificate then? What he can replace is the invoice and packing list and any other, not even packing list, invoice and certain other documents. So basically draft also he will replace. So when the consignee second beni prepared the documents, this certificate, he won't be knowing the applicant or the issuing bank. So what he will do is he will write the first beni's name as the consignee. In this case, the consignee name will be different in case of transfer LCs. A certificate may indicate, Q11, may indicate a different invoice number, invoice date and shipment routing to that indicated on one or more other stipulated documents provided the exporter or consignor shown on the certificate is not the beni. Again, this case happens in transfer LCs. Second beni has sent the documents to the first beni. First beni replaces the invoice and the draft. So, the transfer document means the certificate on this would contain the consignee name as the first beni. Whereas first beni has replaced the draft and invoice. The invoice will contain the consignee name as the applicant. So these two would be in conflict. Similarly, for more videos, you can follow our paid version. For paid version, you can WhatsApp us on this number. The videos are shared with you on Drive. And then once you have downloaded, then you can watch them without internet. You can keep them for lifetime. See here, these videos of CDCS are not only important for your exams, but throughout your career in trade finance, these videos would be useful to you. You can also download YuvaGuru app from Play Store to get these videos, test, question banks with explanations, job openings directly on your mobiles. You can follow us on Facebook on this link. Now, how many videos are there? See here, ISBP, it's 76 videos. In fact, daily or monthly new updations are done. UCP, 57 videos. General videos means other than all these UCP, ISP, ISBP, URR and EUCP, 55 videos. Then EUCP, 12 videos. URR, 27 videos. ISP, 67 videos. Now remember one thing, all these videos cover the latest versions of all these five things, basically five books. To be more precise, ISBP 745, UCP 600, EUCP 1.1, URR 725 and ISP 98. As and when the editions are changed, the videos are changed accordingly, so you need not worry about that. Also, there are 500 plus questions with explanations and correct answers. Sir, explanations are very important so that you understand why the answer is whatever it is given. It also includes doc check case studies similar to that of in-basket and standalone and simulation exercises. Plus, real-time solutions are given on WhatsApp. Also, you have practice tests available on the app, so you can try that also. First thing you need to do is WhatsApp on this number to get the paid version, because on this app you will be needing internet, and if you take the paid version you don't need any internet. So keep studying, keep watching.